I'm Becky. I'm 20 years old, and until recently, I haven't considered how important blood donation actually is. I'm now thinking about giving blood, and I want to find out more. Through my journey, I will uncover both sides of the spectrum, from those life-saving individuals who donate to the people whose lives have been potentially saved. Anyone at any age, at any time, could need a blood transfusion. Did you know that? As of 2008, the World Health Organization estimated more than 81 million units of blood were collected annually. There are many different blood groups. The most common blood group is O positive, with 37% of the UK population, with the rarest being AB negative, with only 1%. The most frequent use of blood is in general surgery, with 23% of all donated blood being used in this situation. I decided to go to the blood donation centre to find out more about blood.
Blood is a, I suppose in essence it's a transport mechanism for carrying oxygen, nutrients such as sugar and proteins around the body. You can't overestimate its importance. Without it, you die. It's the essential thing that carries, one of the main components is the red cells containing hemoglobin. That's the oxygen carrying capacity in your blood. If you don't have any hemoglobin, any red cells, you cannot get oxygen to your tissues. Importantly, things like your brain tissue, and your brain will die. It's so important, we can't really emphasize how important it is. If you ain't got it, you're dead.
Without blood donations, many lives would be lost. So I took to the busy streets of Manchester to ask the public if, like me, they have considered giving blood. Have you ever donated blood?
I've got too many tattoos and piercings and things.
I don't like needles and I don't like the sight of blood either.
I think it is promoted well enough, but I never see anything that makes me want to go, I should really give blood.
I found it quite uncomfortable actually, and I felt a bit faint afterwards.
You have to leave it, 6 months or something after you've had a tattoo, and a year after a piercing or something like that. So I've always been too close to having a tattoo to ever donate blood.
There's a lot of press going around about it, you know, like giving blood and the advertising, but no, I've not really considered it, really.
After such a negative response from the people of Manchester, I decided to find someone who is dedicated to donating blood. I came across a remarkable lady called Jennifer Brett, who has given over 800 pints of blood in her life. So I decided to visit her and find out more.
So hi Jennifer, what made you begin donating your blood?
I had an accident when I was 17 in the Isle of Man, on a motorbike. I ran me knee along a wall, and by the time we got to hospital there was a lot of blood and bits of bone sticking out of my knee. So I decided, because I'd lost quite a bit, that I would start donating when I was old enough, which was 18. I've had several awards, shall we say, at certain times. At 100 you get the plate, at 250 the glass paperweight, 500 the decanter, and then hundreds after that you get a whiskey glass.
What's the main reason that you've actually give blood then?
Just to help people. Somebody of your own might need blood, platelets, plasma.
Some people look at the process of donating blood as quite daunting and scary. What would your personal experience be of donating blood?
Fine. The worst bit was when they prick your finger to see if you've got enough iron. That's the bit that hurts the most.
And what would you say to encourage people who have never donated blood before?
It doesn't hurt. It doesn't take long, and they could be saving lives.
Britain's response to giving blood has never been taken seriously enough. Tony Hancock's The Blood Donor Sketch defines Britain's perception on giving blood.
Well, it won't hurt. You'll just feel a slight prick on the end of your thumb. Well, I'll bid you good day then. Thank you very much. If you want any more, don't hesitate to get in touch with me. Where are you going? Have me tea and biscuits. I thought you came here to give us some of your blood.
Well, you've just had it. That's just a smear.
It may be just a smear to you, mate, but it's life and death to some poor wretch.
There has been many attempts by the media to encourage blood donation, yet the response is not as positive as hoped for.
Give blood and you can save someone's life today. Please don't leave it to someone else. Type your postcode into blood.co.uk.
Only 4% of the population actually gives blood. But the small percentage that does has a massive impact on the lives of others. I'm on my way to see Nick and his wife Gail, whose life has been saved by blood transfusion. Can you tell me a bit about the operation and why you had to have one?
Well, that was for our son. He had a kidney condition he was born with, and slowly over the years it deteriorated. And when he got to the age of, I think it was 17, they decided that he needed to go on the transplant list and he needed to go on dialysis. So before you actually give a kidney, they do a lot of tests on you. One of them is an X-ray, and they check how many arteries are actually coming off the kidney so that they know what they're dealing with. When they did the X-ray, it only showed one, but there was one actually hidden at the back of the kidney that they didn't know. So when they come to take the kidney out, they actually cut the one that was hidden at the back because they didn't see it. And I lost about 4 litres of blood, I think they said it was, which I think is roughly about 8 pints. Through that, that's how I needed the blood transfusion.
What would you say to those people who have never donated blood before?
I would really encourage anybody to give blood, because through the process that Gail went through when she gave her kidney to Sam, an unfortunate thing happened that an artery was cut in one of her kidneys and she lost a lot of blood. And therefore, what they did, she had to have a major blood transplant, and without people like yourself, you're giving tomorrow, if people don't give blood, my wife won't be here now. Simple as that. So it does save lives. And I would encourage anybody to give blood.
So, tonight is the night before I give blood. And after speaking to the people I've spoken to, I'm actually quite happy that I could be saving someone's life. But I'm quite nervous about tomorrow. But I hope everything goes all right. And I'll see you all in the morning. Night. So it comes out quicker. It's amazing to see how much blood actually came out. And the fact that it was still actually quite warm was quite surreal, because it's just come out of your own body. It's amazing. Like I say, as long as it helps someone save their life, then it's all worth it.
And will you be giving blood again?
4 months. And come back and give some. So I'll be queuing up at the door 4 months' time.
If there's one message you could say to someone to encourage them to give blood, what would you say?
Make the appointment and get your donor card today. You best go and donate some blood.